Good morning, students. Today we are going to start the topic Green Revolution. Now, what is Green Revolution? As I discussed in last lecture, that from 1950s to 1965, in these 15 years, only traditional ways of agriculture were adopted. But after 1965, right from 1966, means in the mid 60s, new technology were introduced, and traditionally agricultural practices were gradually being replaced by modern and new farm practices. Two things were done in the Green Revolution. One, well marked improvement in agricultural production in a short period, means in a short period well marked improvement was seen. Well marked improvement means from 10 to 20 million ton to 30, 40 million tons, sometimes 50, 60 million tons in only 20, 25 years. This well marked improvement was seen. And another, it was seen that the sustenance of a higher level of agriculture production over a fairly long period of time. And in fairly long period of time, it was seen sustenance of a higher level of agricultural production. So this was means not only quantitative, even qualitative improvement was also seen with the Green Revolution. Now we are going to discuss over here the positive effects, which is in your syllabus, the positive effects of Green Revolution. Now, what are the positive effects? First is increase in production, especially the production of wheat and rice increased at a very high rate. This was the effect of Green Revolution, increase in production. The major achievement of Green Revolution was the sharp increase in the production of major cereals. Major cereals means mainly wheat and rice. In 1960-65, it was 55.1 million tons, and after 25 years, it was seen that the wheat production reached at 92.3. And in 2015-16, means again after 20 years around, it was seen that the production reached to 92.3 million. It is given, the data are given in your book. And if that production which was increasing, if it is only used by farmers or consumed by farmers, then it will not be said any improvement. But when the production increases that much which is sold in the market, means marketable surplus takes place, then it is called a markable improvement. So there was markable improvement in the production. And second, increase in productivity, which I told you that not only quantitative improvement, even a qualitative improvement was also seen with the Green Revolution. What was this increase in productivity? The new technology was brought about a sharp increase in agricultural productivity in respect of the food grains. For wheat, per hectare production has gone up from 18851 kilogram to 1630, means around double in only 10 years. It was seen that productivity was increasing. Quantitative, qualitative, both the improvements were seen with the help of Green Revolution. Scientific cultivation. Next is scientific. A very important consequence of Green Revolution is that traditional agricultural inputs and practices given away to new and scientific practices. scientific practices, under scientific practices, HYV seeds were introduced. HYV seeds means high yield variety seeds. HYV, high yield variety seeds, means when these seeds are used, there is a high yielding. The production increases much faster, and even the cropping pattern was changed. What was this cropping change in cropping pattern? As a result of green revolution, a change in cropping pattern was observed in two changes were seen. First, the proportion of cereals in the food grains output increased and the proportion of pulses declined. Means proportion of food grains increased, but the proportion of pulses declined. Second, the proportion of wheat within cereals increased while that of coarse grain has declined. So this was seen. Even development of industries took place. Industries were developing faster. Change in attitudes of farmers was also seen. Attitude of farmers was seen. A healthy contribution of green revolution is a change in the attitude of farmers. Our farmers began to think that they can change their misfortunes by adopting new technology. Unlike in the past, they are now giving up traditional agricultural practices for scientific practices. So now scientific practices are being used. Production is being increasing. Scientific methods were used. New seeds were used. High yield variety seeds were used. But this effect was mainly introduced in Punjab, Haryana and West UP, where the production of wheat was much more than other areas. But gradually, even other areas were also given effect of this, were also introduced with the Green Revolution. Green Revolution was also introduced. So here this topic also ends. Today we completed that this particular unit. In our next unit, we will be discussing about the secondary sector and effects in the changes in the secondary sector. Secondary sector, we have already discussed that secondary sector means manufacturing sector. When one thing or one input is changed into another form of goods, that is called secondary sector. That will be discussed in our next lecture. Till then, thank you. Goodbye.